Good evening, and welcome to the third through fifth musical, Once Upon a Parable. It's a pleasure to welcome you tonight. It's great to be together and be led by these students today and this evening. We are thankful for so many different people and their role in this. Thank you to the people in the back with audio and also lighting, which is blinding me right now. This is crazy, really cool. Thank you to the teachers for just all the work and effort behind the scenes that they have gone in rehearsing with these students and practicing with them and encouraging them to get out of their comfort zone, and hopefully you'll experience that as they sing Hallelujah and move their hands and feet tonight. Special thanks to Mrs. Bexford for her guidance and leadership, as well as Mr. DeBone, who put together some drums and is gonna help lead as well. He's even playing, he told me, a brake drum. I don't think it's from his actual car, but we look forward to that as well. And thank you to the students. You guys have been awesome, not just in preparation for this, but for all year. And we appreciate you so much. And this has been an amazing year because of you. And you bring me, and I know the teachers and your parents and everybody else here, so much joy. And I experienced this even this morning, riding in my vehicle over here, transporting a small group of you, just to hear you laugh and giggle and just share life with each other. It has meant so much to me and brings me so much joy. And just know that. Before we begin, let's pray. Brother God, thank you for this evening and this opportunity to be together and to hear your story and to hear these students tell it. May you calm their nerves. May you give them clarity of thought and mind as they remember lines and as they sing. And may they do so for your glory. And may the words that they say and the stories that they have learned, may you plant them deep in their hearts, that they would be rooted in them, and that they would bear much fruit, not just tonight and in this year, but in the years to come. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. smart from the land of Galilee?
Me?
Yes.
Sorry.
Jesus went throughout the land, preaching the good news about God.
Let's see. The kingdom of God is near. Turn away from your sins and believe the good news. Is that right?
Don't quit your day job.
Oh, come on. Nobody's perfect. Well, almost nobody.
Just do your best. Now, Jesus called a special group of people to follow him.
Matthew? Simon?
No!
Judas?
What?
Mary?
Right here.
Martha?
Yeah.
And many others.
Hey, what's up? How you doing?
With these friends, Jesus went throughout the countryside, teaching the crowd using parables.
What?
Yes, Simon?
What's a parable?
It's a simple story with a lesson. As I said, Jesus began teaching the crowds using simple stories with a lesson. He said,
once there was a wise man who built his house upon a layer of rock. And there was a foolish man who built his house upon sandy ground. Then a storm blew in. Rain began to fall. Harder and harder and
degree.
as Jesus was traveling, he began to have problems with the Pharisees, the teachers of religious law.
So, this is the great storyteller.
Stories about you. I heard he lets his followers eat without washing their hands.
Ew!
I heard he eats with sinners and criminals. I think he's got a lot of explaining to do. Is anyone here a lawyer for the High Court?
I am.
Of course. Maximus the Negatius. Why don't we ask him a few questions?
I'd be delighted. Sir, please step forward and state your name.
Jesus of Nazareth.
Mr. of Nazareth, I direct your attention to Exhibit A, the first five Mosaic legal codes. And my question is, according to the law, how can I live forever?
You're the one with all the books. Why don't you look it up?
I don't have to. The answer is, love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul and all your strength and all your mind.
All that. Guess you don't need me.
Objection! The witness is being evasive.
Stay.
Sir, I'm going to have to ask you to be more specific. How do you define the term neighbor?
Let me tell you a little story. It's about a priest, a lawyer, a traveling salesman, and a Samaritan.
You're answering my question with a Samaritan joke?
Woo-hoo!
I love those. I just don't get them.
Well, I don't think we need to hear it. We all know that Samaritans are mean and ignorant.
Yeah.
I think this story might surprise you.
Jericho.
So the story goes.
Very well, case dismissed. Now Jesus and his disciples went on their way, and they came to the village where a woman named Martha invited Jesus into her home. She had a sister named Mary, who sat down and listened as Jesus taught.
You know what the kingdom of God is like? Can you think of a parable for it?
Woo-hoo! I know! I know!
Yes, Simon?
It's the kingdom of God, right? So it's gotta be something
big and strong.
How about a great big castle with
guns sticking out all over it?
No, Simon, that's not it.
No?
No, the kingdom of God is like this, a mustard seed.
That itty bitty thing's gonna grow into a great big tree? No way. I can't even see it.
Oh, I get it.
Yes, Mary?
The kingdom of God is like a precious little seed. You have to keep it safe, right? So you lock it in a pretty, pretty case of stained glass. And you keep it safe forever and ever.
No, Mary, I'm afraid that's not it either.
It isn't?
No, when you want a seed to grow, you have to put it in dirt.
Dirt?
Yeah, and let it crack open.
Ew. That's yucky.
Excuse me, dear. Step aside.
Hey, Martha. Where have you been?
In the kitchen, working alone.
Sorry, I was listening to Jesus.
Well, as a matter of fact, I couldn't help overhearing, and I think I see where the Reverend Jesus is heading with this. It's quite simple. The kingdom of God is like cooking a 7-course dinner, like the one in the kitchen, for example. Now, if you dare to consult my Martha's Guide to Perfect Parties, you'll see. It's to plan the menu. You have to assemble your ingredients, defrost the meat, whip the cream, set the table, cook the food, and work, work, work. That's what serving God is all about. Now, if more of us pitch in once in a while, and I won't name names, even though you do know my sister, I think we can whip God's kingdom into shape. So, Jesus, why don't you tell Mary?
Whoa, Martha. Whoa.
Did I say something wrong?
Martha, your sister is doing the right thing. I just want to spend the time with the two of you.
Oh, well, if that's really what you want, I don't see you can get anything done.
If you plant a mustard seed, you just have to leave it there for a while. Maybe in the night, when you're not even watching, it grows up and puts out branches. And soon, it will be big enough that birds can come and make nests in it. That's what the kingdom of God is like.
Yeah. Jesus entered the town of Jericho and was passing through. In the town, there's a man named Zacchaeus. He was very short. He was also a tax collector, very rich. He wanted to see Jesus, but the crowd was too big.
Excuse me? Can you see him? Is he here yet?
Hey, look who's here. It's Itty Bitty Zacchaeus.
When Jesus got there, he looked up and saw him.
Hey Zacchaeus, come on down. I want to visit your house.
Whoa, Jesus, what are you doing? That guy's a total loser.
Yeah, you don't want to go to his place. Yes, I do. It's why I came, to find things that are lost. What do you say, Zacchaeus?
Nobody ever comes to my house.
Well, I think it's about time.
Zacchaeus was so touched, he climbed out of the tree and said,
Jesus, I'd be honored. To this very day, I'll give away half of what I own.
Ooh!
And if I've cheated anybody, I'll give them back four times of what they own.
Ah!
Guess who's coming to dinner? Didn't take long before the child spent everything she had.
You're
teacher.
Well, then what did he do?
I gave her a party.
What? I should get a party. I did everything right.
This is the last straw. Jesus, your stories don't make any sense.
They're all backwards.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
And Jesus, you think you like surprise endings? Just wait. We have an ending that might just change your mind.
Jeebers, that kind of puts a damper on things.
Oh, I don't know. What do you say?
I say my child was lost.
And now I'm found.
And I say my child was dead.
And I'm alive.
Plot to kill him.
But they didn't do it, did they? I mean, you're the Messiah.
Son of God.
Thank you, Simon, but we all know that there's one more story to tell.
Time to go to the road till love is.
concludes the show. Chorus, you want to take a bow?